Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, with another in the series on the 1877 Crucy tinfoil prototype. Well, working on the reproducer still. New stylus, new spring, and new link. And I'll do a video on this reproducer to explain why it's so difficult to get it to work. It is really, really inefficient. But I could improve on this, but I'm trying to make it as original as possible. This is the way the original machine was, so there's very little you can do with it. It's using a steel diaphragm for the recorder. It's using a mica diaphragm for the reproducer, and the reproducer consists of three separate parts, so it is quite involved for being such a simple machine. So I'm going to do a quick recording to see how this reproducer sounds. I just got it installed and adjusted. So we're going to do a quick recording of Mary Had a Little Lamb on the 1877 Crucy tinfoil prototype.
Hello, hello, hello! Mary had a little lamb. Its fleece was white as snow. And everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go. Ha, ha, ha!
Alright, so we back off the recorder. Rewind the mandrel to the beginning. And now we bring in the recorder, the reproducer stylus. And this is absolutely critical. So I've got a little mark set here. Alright, let's try that. So, here's the recording with the new reproducer. Alright. So, now that it's working, it's just a matter of tweaking it to make it work the best that it possibly can. It is completely inefficient, but remember, this was the original prototype. No one knew how to record sound when this machine was built. So it is really, really inefficient. In fact, after Edison built this machine, he discarded the separate reproducer completely and did everything with one diaphragm. So I just wanted to do a quick video to document this. Just got this installed, made out of actually household parts, and just wanted to test this. Like I said, I'll be doing a video on the reproducer itself. It's quite involved, surprisingly so, for being such a simple application. But I wanted to do a quick video to document the experiment. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email. TheVictrolaGuy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.